All right, guys, we are back in my garage for another video, and today we're going to be taking apart a Gen 1 B58 oil pump. If you guys saw some of my previous videos, then you know that I've taken apart a Gen 2 B58 oil pump that was causing issues on one of my friend's M340Is, and he was having issues with oil pressure. He couldn't measure his oil level in certain conditions, so we were just kind of curious what could be causing that issue. And of course, we know now different details about the plastic internals and potential for it to crack or cause other problems that create those oil issues. But a lot of people after that asked, do Gen 1 B58s have the same problem as well? So now we've kind of got the unique opportunity to open up a Gen 1 oil pump, see if the internals are metal or plastic, and kind of compare it to a Gen 2 pump so we can see what the differences are that might make a Gen 1 pump more reliable than a Gen 2. So let's go ahead and take it apart, and hopefully you guys find this video useful. So if you haven't seen my previous videos, we're working on a B58 engine that came out of my 2016 340i. I bought it from Copart with engine issues, but instead of fixing it, I decided to test my luck. And after making over 600 wheel horsepower for the past several years and a bunch of weekends of track abuse, unfortunately, my luck ran out. So I'm tearing down the engine to find out what went wrong, and in the process, I'm making videos like this one to take a deep dive into some of the engine's internals. So check out the playlist in the video description for all of the videos I've made, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this in the future. So here's what the oil pump looks like, and the way it works is pretty simple. Oil is sucked in at the bottom at the oil pickup, and then it goes up into the oil pump, and as it's turning, it's pressurizing the oil and then pushing it throughout the engine. So that's basically what lubricates your entire engine, by making sure this oil pickup is submerged in oil and then pressurizing it so it gets to all of your critical components. In order to remove it, there are only 4 bolts, so you've got 2 on this side and 2 on this side, and we're just going to use an E10 e-torx socket to unscrew them. Once it's unscrewed, you can pull down on the oil pump. It is a very tight fit though, so you'll kind of have to wiggle it back and forth until the sprocket comes free from the chain, and then the pump is completely removed. All right, so here is our oil pump. I mean, it looks very similar to the Gen 1 oil pump, and I'll bring that over in a minute once we get this kind of taken apart a little bit more so we can see what the differences are. But let's go ahead and take this sprocket off, and then we'll take the cover off and see what's inside. So fingers crossed. I don't know what we're gonna see. I kind of have an idea, but let's see it together. Now this is probably gonna be hard to remove. It is a reverse thread, and it just kind of says to clamp down on the sprocket, but I don't have a tool that can do that. Let's see if we can find a counter hold. Trust me, I'm an engineer. All right, so then we gently take this off. Remember, righty loosey, lefty tighty. Since this is a reverse thread, and the sprocket is keyed, so you can kind of see on this side it's flat, and that lines up with this little flat groove right here. You can kind of see it has a beveled edge right there. And then let's go ahead and take off all of these little screws. All right, I'm really not sure what we're gonna see. Personally, I think it's gonna be plastic. I know a lot of people say that Gen 1s don't seem to have the oil pump issues because they think that it's metal inside, but I've seen some older ones that look like they were plastic as well, so I'm kind of anticipating that the Gen 1 B58 also comes with plastic internals, but you know, the design about it is what prevents it from cracking. Either it's slightly reinforced or maybe higher quality plastic, or you know, all the things that we kind of argued in the Gen 2 oil pump teardown video. But I'm curious. I just want to see for myself. I know this is one of those questions a lot of people don't ask, but we're going to do this for me. And hopefully the 4 or 5 of you that are also curious are entertained by this too. All right, we're down to the last couple screws. Last time to get your votes in. What do you think? Is it going to be metal or plastic? Place your bets. And here we go. 3, you've got to be kidding me. I thought this would come off like the Gen 2 one. You got to like pry this one open. There we go. All right, survey says, oh, it's plastic. Now, I do think it's interesting because we can see the two softer springs, like we've talked about in some of the previous videos. So it doesn't have one stiff spring. It does have two springs that are a little bit smaller. But yeah, I mean, the outside is still obviously plastic. And then the actual wheel in the middle is what's metal. So seems like a pretty familiar design. Let's see, we'll start taking some of these other pieces out. But yeah, I guess this basically confirms it again. Metal in the middle, plastic on the outside. Now, since this is my channel, of course we've got a Gen 2 oil pump that we can compare it to. So you can kind of see how they're different. Again, this one had the one spring. I can't reassemble this and install the spring in there because it's too stiff. But that's what allows this whole assembly to kind of, you know, move around and shift how the vanes are. And then when it turns, you know, that's what actually builds up the oil pressure. So I think the big difference here is that, you know, this support ring, I guess you might say, where all the oil is kind of inside of here where it's building the pressure, is much thicker on the Gen 1 pump compared to the Gen 2 oil pump. And then most of this area where the plastic is surrounding that support ring is much thicker as well. Like you can see the thickness down here and the thickness up here versus the thickness on this Gen 2 pump, especially with this channel. The channel kind of makes it thinner in that area. So it seems like this would be more susceptible to cracking compared to up here where it's much thicker on the Gen 1 pump. So, you know, it kind of is what it is. Let me see. I think we're missing some pieces too. I want this to actually work. So I can't get the dowel out of this cover plate, but the dowel is what goes in here. And that's kind of what this is hinged on. And then I found the dowel for the Gen 2 pump in here. Here it is. And so that fits into this little slot. Hopefully, there we go. And yeah, I mean, you can kind of see how this hinges on it. So even like the dowel for the Gen 1 pump is significantly larger and seems like it's designed to handle more stresses versus this Gen 2 pump. So, you know, I'm sure there's a benefit somewhere. I'm sure somebody determined that this was less weight, more efficient, you know, like the actual cavities in here are much bigger. So it seems like it should be able to flow more oil, which is definitely advantageous compared to these kind of smaller channels with how big the vanes are and everything. It takes up a lot more space. So it's just a different design, you know, but I think this more clearly illustrates the difference between a Gen 1 oil pump and a Gen 2 oil pump and what could potentially be, you know, the downside of what causes these Gen 2 pumps to fail and causes the plastic to crack. So yeah, I'd say that was pretty interesting, something I was super curious about. I know a lot of you guys think these videos are answering questions that nobody's asking, but I really wanted to see it for myself outside of just technical guides and things that we've been using at our disposal lately. So it was cool to see it in person and up close what the exact differences are. So like I said in the previous videos, I haven't really heard of oil pump problems on Gen 1 B58s. I definitely think it's nowhere near as rampant of an issue as it seems to be becoming on Gen 2 B58s. And the easiest way to know is just to measure your oil level, monitor your oil pressure, see if it starts getting higher than it should be. And that will kind of tell you if there could potentially be a problem in yours. So that's really all I had for this one. That's all I kind of wanted to look at. More coming soon again as we continue to dig into the engine and talk about some of the details inside of my engine. But for now, I think that's it for this video. So thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below.